Simmer down now. Beyond Sauerkraut Season 2, Episode 14. Well, it's the dead of winter. You know what that means. It's cold and flu season. We have been battling with colds and viruses for the last 6 weeks, and I think it's finally time for me to make some elderberry syrup. Elderberry has a long medicinal history. It's most known for fighting cold and flu, but also in a study by Penn State, it was proven to be the only compound that could kill the H1N1 virus. Today, we're gonna make an elderberry syrup that's gonna get you through cold and flu season from start to finish. This is another dump and go recipe. For this recipe, you'll need 8 cups of water, 2 cups of dried elderberries, 1 cup of dried tart cherries, 1 cup of organic raw honey, 3 star anise, 1 stick of cinnamon, and 1/4 cup of black pepper. You're gonna add in all of the ingredients except for the honey. You'll add the honey at the very end after everything's boiled, cooled off, and you're getting ready to put it in jars. Stir it around. And turn on the heat. You're gonna bring it up to a boil and then down to a simmer. Ginger! Ginger! Oh my gosh, I forgot to add ginger. You want about 3/4 cup of ginger. So you're going to put a lid on it and bring it up to a boil. Once it's gotten to a boil, you're going to take the lid and pull it halfway off and let it reduce to a nice thick syrup. Let's see how it's doing. Ooh. I think it's time to turn this down. So let's talk about these ingredients a little bit. Why did I put these particular ingredients in this concoction? There's a number of them. I'll give you the most important reasons I put each ingredient in though. So elderberry, because it kills viruses like H1N1. Black pepper, it's antibacterial. Ginger, anti-inflammatory. Cinnamon, antioxidant and anti-inflammatory. Star anise, this one has many, many benefits, but I'll give you the 3 top ones for me. Antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, and antimicrobial. Tart cherries, it's an immune booster, and it's also really good for Troy's. Honey, I didn't know this, but it's a cough suppressant, so if you got something going on here, it'll help with that as well. But it's also an antioxidant. I put all of these together, boil them down into a delicious syrup, And it's like I have my own natural antibiotic. Fire cider and elderberry syrup, I'm good to go.
So we're going to let this simmer down for 2 to 3 hours. We'll come by and stir it occasionally, and then when we're done with it, we'll come back. We've reduced down much quicker than I thought we would. We have lost about 2 cups of liquid, maybe 3. So we're gonna go ahead and stop this and get it strained out.
Normally I would say don't use a metal strainer, but because we're not fermenting anything, it's totally okay.
And we'll get back to you when we're done.
So we got about 2 cups out of that. Now what we're gonna do is put it back on the stove to reduce even more.
We'll reduce this for another 15 minutes. So you can see we reduced another 1/2 inch or so. So we're going to move this off to the side and let it cool to below 120 degrees before we put our honey in.
Well, it's actually the next day. Yep. Yesterday, as the elderberry syrup was cooling, it took a little bit longer than I expected. So I just set it aside and went to bed. We're going to finish up this recipe today. We're going to strain the elderberry one more time, and then we're gonna add the honey.
I have a fine mesh strainer. We're gonna strain that elderberry right through there. Pro tip, wash your pots right away. Otherwise, it's gonna take a long time to get them clean at all. And we add in 1 cup of honey. Get that all mixed up. Nice and thick. The syrup is thick, the honey is thick. This is gonna be so medicinal. All right, let's get that into bottles.
let's go ahead and see how this tastes. It's really got a rich red-brown color to it. And I can smell the tart cherry as well as that sweet elderberry. Mmm. And the ginger comes through as well. This is like my own personal homemade antibiotic. Well, here it is, folks. An elderberry syrup, ginger, tart cherries, black peppercorns, and honey. Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed what you saw today. And if you did, please remember to like and subscribe. And also remember to comment. Don't forget to ring that bell so I can let you know when I'm coming back into your kitchen. Bye-bye!